Hey everybody, welcome to SURVI-VLOG number 27, coming at you from the Bushcraft shelter. So let's go take a look. This is Survivology 101's SURVI-VLOG. And what we do here is we don't talk about survival and the skills and bushcraft and all that really juicy goodies. What we talk about is the hassle and the struggle and the problems with trying to shoot survival and bushcraft and all that good stuff for YouTube. So mostly what I cover are the problems that I have trying to produce good content for you to watch. And that's what this show is about. So right here behind me is the new bushcraft shelter, and I'm pretty stoked. I'm almost done with it. I've worked pretty hard on it the last few days, and I'm pretty excited about showing you the progress that I've recently made, especially my lattice fence. So this fence is basically just a bunch of saplings woven together, a couple of upright posts at, I don't know, close to 3 foot intervals, and then it's just saplings woven in, and I didn't pay a whole lot of attention that every single weave was perfect and each one was the opposite of the other one. I just kind of fit what I had, scrap pieces, in wherever I could make them fit. And so behind me you can see the weave of the overhead. I've got roughly a 45 degree angle on the tarp roof, which is pretty essential to having the right reflection from the fire, so the fire reflects up off the roof and straight back down on my bed, which I still need to work on building my bed. But what I did was, for the first layer of pine boughs, I just went through and poked them through, and then I'd come in here and whatever was sticking through, I'd take it back and weave it back through it. And then I built a decent layer like that, and then I just took all the extra stuff that I had and just piled it up on top to build that layer deeper. And what all these pine boughs are is essentially just whatever I trimmed off of the trees when I was building my fence. So in a survival situation, I would probably want to build this first, but what I did was I kind of went back and forth between building the roof and building the shelter and building the fence so I could gather the right amount of materials to do both jobs completely. And that's what I ended up doing. And I'm pretty happy with it right now. We started to get some rain a little while ago, and well, it didn't come through. It wasn't very much rain, but I'm hoping that we get a lot of rain tonight, and then I can come out here and check this and make sure that it's not coming through the shelter and it's staying dry. And I'm also considering putting a little bit of a porch on this, like a little bit of an awning that comes out, because I'm gonna move my fire out just a little ways so that it's not tipping the trees up above me, because I have a lot of trees right up above me, or tree branches anyway, and I don't want the flame to lick those. But I usually keep a pretty small flame for a shelter like this. But in the winter time, I'm gonna put clear plastic here and then line this with reflective material and make it into kind of a super shelter so that I can also sleep out here in the winter. And it's coming along really well. I have one more wall to build right there. That wall's only partly done, whereas the one behind me is as high as I'm gonna make it. I like having that little window in there. And you know, I want to say that, you know, the idea of this fence wasn't to keep the critters out. I don't really worry about those. I've been out plenty of times, and I've never had any issue with critters, bear, wolf, or anything like that. The fence is to define the space, and once I finish building the bed and finish that back wall there, I think the space is pretty much complete, and then I can start building like a workbench, maybe a shaving horse, a table, the fire pit, the other things that I need to kind of function in this space. But the beauty of it is, for the most part, it's done enough that I can start using this area for my vlogs, and I can take down the wall tent because I need to take that away to some gatherings. And that brings me to my next point, is that I think it's next week, Mikhail Makiryov from Emberlit is going to be up here, and he'll be here for a day or so, and then we're packing up and we're going to Between the Rivers. We're both teaching different little classes there, and then when that's over, we're coming back here. We'll be here for about a week, refitting, and then we're heading off to Canada for the Global Bushcraft Symposium. And I hope I get to see a lot of you guys there. That would be really amazing. And the drawback to that is that I'm not going to be shooting a lot of videos. Well, I'm going to be shooting a lot of videos. I'm just not going to be able to upload any videos. I'm crossing my fingers that at these two locations, I actually have reception so I can do some live broadcasts. And I'll go live more than just Sunday. I'll try to go live, you know, if I can swing it, I'll go live every night on just my phone. Maybe I'll go live and interview some people if they're up for it. Or maybe I'll go live around the campfire when people are singing and doing their thing. That would be outstanding if I can pull that off. But I don't know if I'm going to have reception. So that all remains to be seen. All right, so that's it. I'm going to show you the roof real quick. See, it's got a pretty good layer. It could use some more, and that will happen over time as I strip down more branches to build various different contraptions. You see how that is? It should be a little deeper, but right now I've got maybe from my shoulder to my elbow deep on it. I want my shoulder to my fingertips deep, so I'm going to have to build this out. But I'll do that as I gather more materials naturally, just doing the work around the land and building the other contraptions in and around my camp. So you can see the fence here. And I didn't make the fence too high. I made it high enough so that I can just step over it if I want to. Like I said, it's mostly just to define the space. And, you know, sort of give like a little yard type area. And I'm real happy with it for that purpose. So I wanted to show you something my wife made me. And because I'm going to these gatherings, I wanted a belt sheath for my axe or my hatchet. So I have this Grandsforce wildlife hatchet, which I'm real fond of. You know, I got a lot of Husqvarna axes and all that kind of stuff, but this is pretty top notch. And I really like carrying this hatchet. So she made me this nice little belt sheath for it. And it's like, you know, your old standard Boy Scout style sheath, so I can wear that on my belt. I have this stupid leather thong on it. I think I'm going to take that off. But I can basically wear that on my belt and have the axe with me at all times. And it fits really good. I'm real happy with it. Got a nice black edge, an oversized belt loop so it hangs just a little below the belt. And it's stitched with a green thread, so she'll probably pull this black thread out of here and put a green in so everything matches. And I know it's kind of trivial that, oh wow, all your gear matches, but as long as we have the capability to make it and to make the stuff match, then why not? You know, why wouldn't we put the pieces together so that they all look the same and fit well? And you know, she uses the same scallop border on all of my gear, usually the same leather and the same colors. You know, it's just kind of one of those things I'm fond of, but she really tuned up it really tunes up the whole package to have that cool sheath. And then and something else I made this little birch bark container. And I took a little extra piece of birch bark to reinforce the edge because they have a tendency to want to split at the top. And then it's a weave pattern. I don't know if you, it's a neat little weave pattern where the where the pieces of bark kind of puzzle link together with each other. So it's pretty neat. It's just something I made for myself, but what it holds, whoops, it's got a little pine lid on it, and it's got a pine bottom, and it's actually a case for my hearing aids, because I have like severe hearing loss, so I keep my hearing aids in a nice little case. Made of birch bark. So that's kind of cool, you know. I mean, they come with a nice little hard plastic case and everything, but this is just as protective, but it's much more natural and much more me. If I have to take some crazy electronics to the field, I might as well have them in a nice natural case, you know. I don't know, I mean, you know, maybe I'm just weird, but it's still pretty cool. I'm pretty fond of it. So yeah, that's what I've been up to. I've been out here just banging away trying to get this shelter done, and I think I'm in the final throes. And I will admit, see, I'm doing a video for it, but I'm gonna admit that I'm pretty shitty about recording my work. I'll show a few steps through the process, and it might be entertaining and maybe it won't, but I'm pretty bad about just recording everything I'm doing and getting the right angles and all that kind of stuff. I generally start to record and then I have some flaw, like it won't focus or the battery goes dead or some crap like that, and then I just do the work. And I'm getting better at that. I'm trying to anyway. I'm trying to get better at just fixing my technical problem and then getting the work done on camera, but I'm not there yet. I tend to just put my head down and get the work done, and then I look back and I'm like, man, I should have recorded that. And so that's just like my struggle. That's part of my struggle. And you know, that's what this is. That's what this vlog is about. It's about my struggle to produce outdoor content. So that's just one of the things that I have an issue with. I don't want to film it. I just want to work. I just want to get it done. And then when I'm done with it, I'm like, man, it wouldn't have taken that much more effort to just film it and have a video. And you know, because I've done multiple projects today besides working out here. I repaired an old fishing rod that I broke the tip off of, so I shortened it down and then reused the old tip. I drilled it out and then re-glued it on and set the old tip, so I had this real stiff, short fishing rod that fits perfectly in the back of my truck, so I never ever have to be without a fishing rod. So anytime I'm rolling around and I see a piece of water that looks like good fishing territory, I can always just grab my rod and go fish, because I'm always licensed. And so yeah, I broke that rod the other day and I thought, man, I might as well make a good travel rod out of it, and that's what I did. So I did that project today, and I think I did another one, and then I made that birch container. And you know, those kind of things, like, they would be great videos, but I'm real lazy about, I just want to get in the work and I just want to get it done and have the product at the end. And I always forget or neglect to set up the camera and film it and do it right. And I'm learning how to do that. And the more I learn my camera and the more I learn about editing, the easier that becomes, but I'm nowhere near there yet. So I imagine some of you can probably identify with that, that if you have a YouTube channel, that you do something cool and you're like, man, I should have filmed that, but I didn't even know if it was gonna work. What I'm trying to come to terms with is the fact that I can film all of it, and it's not like it's live. It doesn't have to go out unless I want it to go out. And I always look back and think, man, I should have filmed that. I should have filmed that. I should have recorded that. And I never do. And that's just one of the things that I'm going to have to come to terms with, and I'm going to have to figure out how to fix mentally on me, is that when I'm doing a project, I need to just turn on the camera and do the project for you. And I'm working on that. But in the meantime, you got the vlogs, and occasionally I make a decent video, and you know, that's best I can offer right now, but I'm getting there. And that's what this vlog is about. This vlog is about the process of getting there. You know, I look at some of those other channels, and those guys got it dialed in. Like, they know. I'm going out to do this, these are the steps I'm going to take. At least that's the illusion that I'm having. You know, I get the illusion that they're walking out there with a purpose. They're going to do this, they're going to do it in this order, and then they're going to send the video. And I don't feel like that. I feel like every video is a struggle, not only to do the project, because I never know how it's going to turn out. All these things are new to me. Not the survival stuff, most of the stuff I've done before, but when I'm doing projects, like random off-the-wall, one-off projects, they're new to me, and I have no idea how they're going to turn out. But man, I love to just jump in there and just get them done. And I'm going to have to start taking you guys for that ride. And you know, it doesn't hurt. Do you hear that train? Wow, that's annoying. It doesn't hurt me to just record them, and then if it doesn't turn out, then do something else. And yeah, I don't know. I'm going to have to get better at it. So that's what I'm saying. That's part of the struggle. That's part of Survivology 101, or the SURVI-VLOG anyway, is trying to learn how to do that, how to capture that, and how to be present in the moment while filming it. Because filming really does take you out of the moment, out of what you're doing. You know, it's one thing to process materials and build a shelter. It's another thing to record yourself processing materials and building a shelter. That in my hat goes off 100% to those guys that are pulling it off and doing it really, really well. I don't know how they do it. I'm learning. I'm trying to figure it out. But those guys are really, a lot of those guys are really good at with some of the survival and the bushcraft channels. And I hope to one day be able to perform like that, where I can go out and do it and record it, you know, solo. Like, for the guys that got like a whole team behind them, and you got like cameramen, and you got sound guys, and you got all that, hey man, you know, good on you for having that kind of resource. But for me, it's a one-man show. This whole shelter, every single branch was cut with a folding saw, and every branch was delimbed with the hog that I made in my shop. And yeah, I mean, the ground was leveled by me, all the filming was done by me, and it's a lot of work, and it's difficult to make it all happen when it's easy enough to do the work and just leave the cameras laying over there somewhere and not turned on. And that's the struggle, is to turn on the camera and just record it, and then not lose the footage. Because I do have some snippets of footage, some time lapses and whatnot, that I've shot out here while I was doing this that I've lost. I don't know where they're at. I don't know if I erased the footage, or if I initialized the card, or I don't know. I have some footage that I cannot find. And that's kind of a bummer. But I'll do my best now that the shelter's almost done. You'll probably see this vlog on Saturday, I'm thinking. And hopefully sometime this next week, I'll be able to get the bed finished built and then start editing and getting the vlog together, or the video together on this whole contraption. And I'll do my best to edit the little bit of footage that I have into a decent video on building this shelter. But the bottom line is, now I have all kinds of cool projects that I can do in here, and this can be my outdoor studio, I guess, for lack of a better term. So I have a place where I can stay the night, do cool stuff. And when I say stay the night, like, I can stay the night in the forest, but it's also a pain to pack up. Not only do I have to pack my gear for an overnight, but I have to pack all the camera equipment to bring with me, and then figure out how to get it there, and then either drive there, hike there, four-wheeler there, all that kind of stuff. It's so much easier to be here on my own property, and I just throw on my backpack, bring out my camera gear, set it up, and then if I need any other gear, I can just go back and get it for the video. Because it is a different world, like it is smoke and mirrors. I don't want to dispel the fantasy for those that are trying to live it, but YouTube videos are smoke and mirrors, and a lot of it is not real true to life. And like me, like I'm on the backside of my own property and I can go back to the house and do what I need to do, but we could do this in my office. We could do this survivalog in my office, but who wants to see me sitting in my office? Why don't we sit out here at the camp and do it here? So with that, I love you for being here. Thanks for sticking around to the end. I very much appreciate it. If you want to, if you're into it, go ahead and smash that subscribe, smash that like button. If you're not into it, hey, dude, I get it. All right, then, I'll see you on the next one.